I had just realized that I'd never talked about the Cheers segment of the Earth Day special. I had seen this quite a while ago, probably around the time I started watching Cheers, and that was before I was reviewing each episode in turn. I have since then reviewed several Cheers specials and segments, so I thought, let's go back and watch this. And I'm glad I did, because it's an absolute delight. The Cheers segment is maybe 2 minutes, so there will of course be spoilers as I explain what happens, but if you're a Cheers fan, absolutely check it out. The Earth Day special in general is really good. It was released in 1990, and basically we have a whole bunch of celebrities, comedians, Robin Williams has a great role to play in this, and different TV shows coming together to deliver messages about how to protect the Earth. And obviously it's done for the most part with comedy to be engaging and entertaining, but with some really important messages for the 90s, but messages that are still relevant today. And in the Cheers segment, the gang are talking about ways that they can do their part, which of course is what the special is all about. So I will share what they all come up with, but it's very straightforward. We just have the gang there talking about it. There's nobody else in the bar. We have Sam, Rebecca, and Woody behind the bar. We then have Norm, Cliff, and Frasier there. Carla isn't there, which is a shame, but what we get is still pretty great. So I will now share the tips that they give, but I can just sum up first of all, if you haven't seen it and you're a Cheers fan, it's delightful, it's funny, it's a nice little 2 minute segment, and I rather enjoyed rewatching it. So Sam comes up with the idea of buying his hair products, his grooming products, in larger containers. So instead of having more plastic for the same amount, he's buying larger containers. So yes, it's still plastic. He's still throwing away these containers at the end of it, but there's less plastic for the volume of hair product, etc. And we have a visual aid with this one, as he conveniently he positions them on the bar, and we already have quite large containers, but actually these are the products he's already using. He's going to buy them in larger packaging. And we then have Norm. Norm was an absolute delight in this. Norm's contribution is absolutely my favorite here. Norm says that whenever he buys a six pack, he's going to make the effort to snip the rings of the six pack. Obviously that's important to help prevent wildlife from getting trapped in the six-pack rings, and he's also going to take the cans that he's collected from his beers and trade them in for money, because in the States, I don't know if this is still a thing, I assume it is, please feel free to provide me with that information, but you can trade in cans for a couple of cents a can to encourage recycling. And they ask him what he's going to buy with the money he gets, and I knew what was coming. I didn't know what he was going to say, but I knew the joke would imply that Norm had this excessively large stash of empty beer cans, and he says he's going to buy a car with the cans, a more environmentally friendly car with the cans, nevertheless. Cliff's contribution may not be the most useful, but he tried. He's going to write a note to everybody on his mail route telling them to recycle their junk mail and catalogues, which I guess is not a tremendously bad idea. It may not work, but it's worth a try. He also said he's going to actually write the notes on the junk mail so he's not wasting more paper, which, yeah, that was actually a pretty good idea. Rebecca has decided that she's going to walk down to the laundry instead of driving, and she's also going to take her own garment bags instead of using the plastic bags that they give her. I have no idea what she's talking about, but apparently they give you plastic bags to put your clean laundry in, I guess. I don't know why you can't just put it in the laundry bag itself, so I'm not 100% sure what she's on about, but it sounds like a nice idea anyway, and certainly the emphasis on driving less and walking more is good. And we end with a great quote from Norm, which is very much a Norm thing, but I love it. And he says, just by sitting around and doing nothing for the rest of our lives, we're doing our part. And everybody agreed. And obviously the point there is that if you don't drive around so much, you are helping. Norm took it a little bit further by saying, well, if I just sit on my butt all day instead of driving around, I'm saving the planet a bit more, then fair enough. The point is not inaccurate, I guess, but I rather liked it, and I thought it was really well done. Some really great tips in here. I think they had some really good points to make, some maybe more helpful than others, some that are definitely still relevant today. I think some of them would be different today. For example, I don't think Sam's point would be to just buy grooming products in larger containers. I think it would be more about focusing on using more environmentally friendly products. And I feel like Norm's snipping his six-pack rings maybe could still be there today. There is a lot of awareness still being raised about the dangers of rings that come on packs of cans. But I think the message would probably be don't buy packs of cans with six-pack rings where possible anyway. Cliffs could probably be more so about encouraging people who create junk mail to not do that, because that's a tremendous waste of trees. And there are, of course, in this day and age, a lot more environmentally friendly way of advertising. Rebecca's point about walking more rather than driving to the laundry, absolutely, that would certainly be something that would be mentioned today. There'd probably be a point in this as well about switching to a hybrid car or an electric car if you can. So definitely some exceptionally relevant points in there, even for today, and some that I think might be a little bit different, but everything here still does apply. And of course, it was all delivered with comedy and a delightful interaction between the gang at Cheers over the course of the 2 minutes or so. If you haven't seen the Earth Day special, I'd say it's worth checking out. We have bits from the Golden Girls, and a very young Neil Patrick Harris is involved. And it's brilliant to see so many huge names coming together with so many brilliant messages. But if you're just interested in the Cheers segment, then go and check it out. It's towards the end. I didn't write down the exact time because I didn't think to, so my apologies there, but it is towards the end of it. But whether you watch the Earth Day special in its entirety, or if you just check out the Cheers segment, if you're a Cheers fan, it's definitely worth watching. I had a lot of fun with it, and obviously the messages, really important, really significant, even today. And Norm is just an absolute delight. I love Norm. And the Cheers segment of the Earth Day special is something that's definitely worth checking out.